Today, we will do some combinatorial study of simplicial complexes. Of course, there is some topology there, but mostly it is the relation between, where something is incident and so on, neighborhoods and such things, which are all studied by combinatorial relation. Combinatorial relation is precisely which face is where, that kind of information. These things are useful if you are doing many more combinatorial problems and also triangulation of manifolds and various things, polyhedral topology and so on. Within this course, we are not going to use this one. So there is less emphasis on this one. That's one reason why I have put it at the end of the study of simplicial complexes. Just because we are not going to study much of it doesn't mean that this is less important, okay? So for this study to begin with, you can just concentrate on finite simplicial complexes. To get a hold on what is going on, okay? But all the definitions and all the results, except when I state it clearly, they are valid for any simplicial complex. But to get your ideas clear, you just work on some finite simplicial complex, what is happening, okay? So take a finite simplicial complex, FB, any simplex in K. Recall, we have already defined this open simplex to be the subset of mod K, which consists of all alpha in mod K with alpha V not equal to 0 for every point V inside F, and conversely, that is, alpha is not equal to if and only if V is inside F. So roughly speaking, if inside mod F, which is all alpha V such that the support is contained inside F, okay, so this set is actually the interior of that. It may not be the interior of mod F, inside mod K. This will be an open set and interior of something, provided F is a maximal simplex. So all this we have seen. In general, this open simplex need not be an open subset of mod K. In fact, this is open if and only if F is a maximal simplex. Note that mod F is equal to open F if and only if F is a singleton. All these things we have seen, but I am just, drawing your point again, drawing your attention to these things. An important thing to note is that open simplexes of in any simplicial complex form a partition of mod K. This is a fact we have used also. Okay. Now let us do a little more. Now take L to be a subcomplex of K and FB inside L. Then look at all simplexes H such that H union F is still a simplex of L. It must be a simplex of L, not of K, okay, inside L. H union F should be a simplex. Then you put H in this one, in this collection. In particular, F union F is also there, right? So F will be also there and subsets of F will be also there. Okay, once something is simplex, all subsets of H will be also there. Not only that, even subsets of F are also there. So this thing forms a subcomplex of L. I just told you why, if H prime is a sub of H, then H prime union F will be also simplex because L is a subcomplex. So this has a name, this is called star of F. And we denote it by star of F in L, because these things are taken inside L. Okay. In particular, if L is the whole of K, then we can take ST, you know, suffix K, or you can just drop it. Because the ambient simplicial complex K is fixed, there may not be any need to write it. The star of F, if you take various different subcomplexes, that will be different, because then it will be only those things which are inside that subcomplex is taken. That's all. The modulus of star F, which is the underlying topological space, is naturally identified with the subspace of mod K. Okay, this is true for any subcomplex after all. All right. And this is nothing but the union of all closed simplexes mod G in K that contain F. G, if contains F and it is a subcomplex of K, it will be inside star by definition. Okay, this subspace is referred to as closed star of F. Okay, it's called closed star of F. In K, it is the closed subspace of mod K containing mod F. Okay, it's quite large, of course, not a smaller order. The mod F itself is closed, but this will be another large closed subset. It's called closed star of F. There will be an open star also. We will define that soon. In contrast, there is a, you see, this is capital ST, here small ST. Small ST of F, defined as the union of all open simplexes. Okay, G open, such that G is a simplex of K containing F. This is called the open star of F in K. Clearly, this is an open subspace of mod K, because you have taken all open subsets larger than that also. So it will be open subspace of mod K, and it contains this open F. So this open F is dangerous. You have to be very careful with this. For example, this open F does not contain all points of mod F. Okay, it may not contain, it actually does not contain mod F in general. Okay, maybe this will contain only if F is a singleton. For example, inside a triangle, empty triangle, okay, only three sides are there. Take one of the sides as F, then what is open F? Open F is the open interval of that, except the 2 points are gone. Now, what is open star of F? That you have to take. Of course, you have to take this cell, and then you can take a triangle and take the open triangle. So this will be the open triangle union the open simplex on one side, whichever one you have taken. Okay, so that will be the open subspace of it's called open star of containing this one, open star of F, where F was one of the edges. Okay, so this example, whatever I given, must make it clear what is happening here. Inside the closed triangle, the full triangle, okay, this open star will be an open subset. Now I define another concept called link. Okay, so this topic is called links and stars. So another concept called link. The link of F in L, so L is a subcomplex, F is some simplex and so on, of F in L is defined to be the subcomplex of the star of F. Remember, what is star of F? It contains all G, such that G union F is a simplex inside L. You look at that, but only take those consisting of simplices which are disjoint from F. Say some G is there, G intersection F is empty, but G union F is inside L because it must be in star L. So if it is far away, then that will not be taken. The collection of all such things will be called link of L, link of F inside L. Once again, if L is the whole of K, we just drop this suffix and merely write a link of F. The underlying topological space is naturally, it is a subspace of mod the closed star of F, and of course it's a subspace of mod K also. And what is this one? Union of all closed simplex mod G is a set inside this one, which are disjoint from mod F. Okay. So I will give you examples of links also. First, by just purely combinatorially, observe what happens to dimension of star F. Dimension of star F is actually equal to dimension of link F plus dimension of F plus 1. Why? Look at any simplex here. Okay, what is the definition? It is G union F inside that one, which is simplex, right? And what is simplex here? It is G union F, but G intersection F must be empty. So starting with a simplex here, you write it as G union F, where G intersection F is empty. You can write any union as disjoint union, right? Because F is a subset. Then that G, which is disjoint from F, will be an element here. What is the dimension of G disjoint union F? Number of elements in G plus number of elements in F, right? Minus 1. The dimension of each of them is number of elements minus 1. Therefore, you get this plus dimension of plus plus 1. This F is kept fixed. The element which comes here is disjoint from F, such that union is here. So this formula is obvious. Okay, so that is what I mean by what we are doing is purely combinatorial, no topology here as such. But this is a combinatorial. But now I'll tell you a stronger result, which is topology here, okay, or geometry. And that is the result here. Take any simplicial complex, any face F, okay, we have the star of F. I am not writing the subcomplex here, L, but if you write that, that will be also true because this is true for every simplicial complex. Okay, I can put an L here, then it will be all true. Star of F is equal to link of F. What is this one? The join. Join with F. What is this F? F is a simplicial complex itself. It's like a delta N, if N is the dimension of F. All subsets of that are also taken here. That is the meaning of F, okay, as a simplicial complex. So you take the join of these two, you get this one. So this is again combinatorial, but what is the meaning of this when you pass through the geometric realization? Geometric realization of star FF is homeomorphic to the join, namely the geometric realization of link star with, this is join, geometric realization of F. This part we have already seen. For any K1 and K2, you first take the join, then take the underlying topology in mod K, mod of that is same thing as first take the mod and then take the join. Okay, so only this part you have to check. And this is precisely the kind of thing I did here. For each f here, this is disjoint from, every element here is disjoint from that, but the union is in the link, in the joint, and you have to put it here by definition. And conversely, starting with anything, you can rewrite it as f disjoint union g, that g will be here, and f will be here. Okay, it may happen that it is not the full f, it may be some part of it, right? So that's what you have to be careful about this. All right. So suppose I take a subset here. By very definition, all subsets of that will have to be also there because this is a simplicial subcomplex. So after taking this one, you can take the subset also there. Now here is, okay. In particular, yeah. In particular, so I saw this one already, but here is, I have given the explanation here. So this is all standard, straightforward. You have seen it several times. Now, as a consequence, in a particular, take any point inside the open simplex. Then we have link of f, okay, start with the boundary complex of f, okay, instead of taking the full thing, is contained inside link of f star with the whole thing minus x, right? X is a single point here. So you throw that. That point is not there anyway in the whole thing also because you have taken on the boundary here. But this itself is the full star minus the point, okay? This much is obvious, but what happens is this is a deformation retract of the star of f minus x. This subspace here is a deformation retract. What does it mean? That there is a homotopy of the identity map of this one. Okay. At the end, it is a retract. It's a map onto this part, which is identity on the boundary, on this part. Okay, so here is the proof. Fix a homeomorphism from the boundary complex star singleton x, this is a cone, it's the whole fist. We know this one. You fix some linear homeomorphism, t times this plus 1 minus t times that, etc. Fix a homeomorphism. Then look at link of f star bf star x. So this I already know. I'm taking again the join with this one, link of f. This is homeomorphic to mod f, right? Boundary of star x, link of x star, I am putting bracket here, that's all, by associativity. First bracket was here, now the bracket is here. But once this is f, I can put f here. Link of f star f, we have seen that it is star of f. Okay, so this is one way of looking at it. On the other hand, we know that for any space y, the base y cross 0 of the cone is a deformation retract of the entire cone minus the apex. Okay, I use that. Take y here to be link of f star bf. This is the base and that is the cone. Okay, so conclusion is that the star of f minus this point will deform retract onto this part. Okay. So we have developed these things earlier in abstract. So I'm applying it in the special case here. Now, K base simplicial complex, F and G be any two disjoint faces of a face F union G. You start with the face and then write it as disjoint union. That's all I'm talking about in K. Then look at the link of F in star of G. Okay, look at the star of G it contains f because g composite g union f is a simplex. Therefore, this makes sense. So f is some simplex in the subcomplex. This is my taking star of g is like a subcomplex L. Okay, the link inside this one of f is star of g in the link of f. Now you can see why the title of this section was links and stars. Link of the star is star of the link. Okay, of course f and g get interchanged. F, g, g, f. Okay, purely combinatorial result. There is no topology here, you see, it's just combinatorial result. You have to check left hand side equal to right hand side. Take a simplex here, show that it is here, and vice versa. Okay. So, okay. First, observe that F intersection G is empty. This started assumption. And the union is in K. Therefore, this G, okay, is in the link of F. And this F is in the star of G. Okay. Therefore, under the given hypothesis, namely F and G, etc., are disjoint, what we have is, suppose L is subcomplex, L is not a subcomplex, L is a face of star of G in the link of F. I am starting from here. This just means, and it's if and only if L is first of all in the link of F, and L union G must be in the link of F. That is the definition of star. Right? But that is the same thing as saying L union F is a simplex in K. L intersection F must be empty because it is in the link. L union G union F must be inside K. And L union G, there is something wrong here. L union G must be also inside K. Okay. So this is same thing as L union G inside K. L intersection F is empty. L union G union K inside K. I am just rewriting this one. So nothing is lost here. But this is the same thing as L inside star of G, by the definition, L intersection F is empty, L union F is in star of G. This is the definition of, because L union F, union G is inside K, so this is in star of G. Okay, so notice that to prove something inside link of F and link of G, I am going all the way to K. Okay, because these things were taken inside K. Link of F is inside K. Similarly, star of G is also inside K. So that's why I am going inside K. So this just means that L itself is in the link of star of G. This is in star of G. And it is intersection with F is empty. Therefore, this is inside link of F. And this is all reversible. All implications are reversible. That's what we are saying. Okay. This result was used by Munkres in deriving something about some result which algebraists were interested in. I am not able to state it here in this particular case. To prove that result, this is called Reissner's condition for a topological space to be a homology sphere. So Munkres proved that such a condition is true for whatever the kind of thing they assume. And that became key result for Reissner to prove his result in combinatorics, which was in turn used by Stanley to prove a big theorem of upper bound conjecture and so on. Okay, so there are history here. So that is one of the ideas why I just spend some time on these links and stars. The only thing is, unless you are familiar with, little more familiar with them, even the definition you may forget. Okay. So to get familiar, you can start, you can solve a few exercises here, which I have mentioned. Okay, for example, show that star of G inside star of F, okay, is star of F intersection star of G, both taken inside K. The only thing you have to assume that is F union G is a simplex. Then something happens. You can just prove or disprove it. Then you will know, you would have worked out, you would have known whether you have understood these things correctly. Okay. So that is all for today. Thank you.